Americans have been rightly surprised and disappointed by the delay in making testing available for the novel coronavirus. While the nation's hospitals and commercial laboratories have been courageous and even heroic in their work to ramp up testing in the face of numerous barriers, many obstacles still remain. Most notably is that there's a shortage of necessary supplies, including sample collection and testing components. Laboratory experts also need special nasal swabs to collect the specimens intended for molecular tests. Unless these supply chain issues are resolved, the nation's laboratories will remain stymied in their attempt to maximize testing capacity. At this point, the biggest barrier to testing is not capacity, but access to vital supplies. We in the laboratory community have asked the federal government to help address this issue. They are the only entity in this crisis with the power to source the necessary supplies on a large scale. In the meantime, we know that people who suspect they have COVID-19 may have trouble accessing the test, and even if they're given a test, it may take up to 2 weeks to get results. The reason for this is that to deal with supply chain shortages, laboratories have to prioritize tests. We have to make sure the sickest people are treated most quickly. Our hope is that the federal government, collaborating with states and private companies, will continue to work to change the supply chain issues we are seeing, and that we will soon have the resources to test all people for this disease and finally have the information we need to reopen the country.